Such wonderful speeches. I am actually a little overwhelmed and intimidated, and I don't have a magic brilliant idea that could change the world, because I think you all did, you spoke all, you said it all. Nazma and you have done a fantastic job. I'll repeat a quote which I think some of the girls have said about, the quote goes something like, I am only one, but still I am one. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. And just because I cannot do everything doesn't mean I refuse to do something. In a world with a population of about 9 million, it is a bit daunting to wonder, what is that idea which could change the world? What is it that I can do? What are these ideas? I thought a lot, and I thought of two or three things which I'd like to share with you, about three or four ideas which I think in our own way can change the world. The first idea I'd like to share with you is a simple thing of looking at the bright side. Always try to find the silver lining in that dark cloud. The second one is something that Muneet spoke about, the three R's. The third idea is an idea which is to live a life of service, to surely have service in our lives. And the fourth one, and the most important one, is the idea of using our voice. I'll start with the first one, which is to see the positive. I think that there is no situation that cannot be turned around to your benefit. So you're sitting in a doctor's office and there's a line of about 50 people before you. You have an hour to wait. That hour could be used to reflect, to think. That hour could be used to make friends. You could actually make a lifelong friend. You could actually help a stranger who's probably really low and depressed. Not being chosen for the council or into a particular team could actually be a stepping stone for you to work so hard that you could never be passed up again. Talking of the three R's, I think you all know the importance of reducing, reusing and recycling. There's one more thing that I'd like to add to you middle schoolers, because you know some of you now get proper money and now have started online shopping. Children, the idea of ethical shopping. When you buy a product, you must know where that product is coming from. You must know how it was made. Because if that product was made by polluting the environment or by resorting to cruelty to some animal for testing, and when you buy that product, you are actually silently endorsing the product. And you are saying that you are all right with the kind of inhumanity that they are creating. The next thing that I want to speak to you about is service, which I think we all know how it gives us pleasure, how we enjoy it, how it gives us satisfaction, and I'm sure we can do service everywhere, at home, at school, helping the elderly, helping the sick. And the last one, and the most important one, is to use our voice. It's the only thing we have. I think education teaches us just to open our minds, and when we open our minds, we have an opinion. When we have an opinion, we stand up and use our voice. We stand up and speak for people who cannot. We use our voice. And that, to me, is the true essence of education. I'll end again by saying, I'm only one, but I am one. I can't do everything, but I can do something. And if I can't do everything, I must not refuse to do something. Together, we can create a ripple, a giant wave, and then a tsunami. And one little step in the right direction can actually move mountains. Thank you.